Today, we are doing the second lecture on NMR. Yesterday, we discussed what?
The environment.
Then different proton environments in organic molecules, right? Like for example, just to recap, we did things like the ethanol molecule, for example, is CH3CH2OH. And these three H's were a particular environment, and these two H's were another particular environment, and the last one, the H and the OH, is another particular environment. And we used HA, HB, and HC to actually just give them labels. And so what this meant was that when I look at the graph of this eventually, I'll actually see three peaks, because there are three proton environments. And the heights or the areas of those peaks will be the number of protons in each of these. 3, 2, and 1. Or the areas will be 3:2:1. We saw all of that yesterday, right? You remember that, guys? Today we're going to talk about you do three peaks here, because I'm literally going to get three peaks. I'm going to get three signals. One will have a height of 3, one will have a height of 2, and one will have a height of 1. Heights or areas, right? And the Cambridge exam actually will label them also with their actual number. But what I'm going to worry about now is that, okay, that I know I'm going to get three peaks, I am going to get three peaks of these heights or areas. But where on the x-axis of the graph will these peaks occur? And the value on the x-axis will be the what we call the chemical shift. So let's talk about that today. So the position of each of the peaks, those positions depend on the chemical shift values. Each, in an NMR spectrum, each proton environment, like for example, in a previous example of ethanol, main wapas niche likh raha hu so that I can talk about that still. So this is CH3CH2OH, and the three environments were the HAs, HBs, and HC. Now each of these three environments is going to show up as a peak, and the height will be the number of protons, but the x-axis value will give me the environment's chemical shift. Now, first of all, yesterday we only discussed the different types of environments and how many atoms would be in that environment. Now what we have to do is we have to be able to talk about the type of environment. Okay, I mean, for example, it's very easy to talk about HC's type of environment. The HC is what? It's a hydrogen on an oxygen, which is part of an alcohol group. So for me to say that HC has this environment is quite obvious, isn't it? The H on an O. So two things you have to do today, actually three things, but two, the first two things are to identify the environment structure and then corresponding x-axis value, which is called the chemical shift. So first we'll talk about what are the type of environments that we have. In this example, you got the H that's bonded to the O, you got the two H's bonded to the C, and you got the three H's bonded to this C. And each of these three are different environments, and we got to label them what kind of environments are they. This one is easy. This one is an H on an O. These three H's are basically what? They are, each of these HAs is an H bonded to a carbon atom that is bonded to another carbon atom and has two other bonds with H's. So this HA is what we call, has this kind of environment. So we call it an CH proton, like for example. And while this is an OH proton. So the type of proton, and this is a term that will be used, type of proton. When you will hear the term type of proton, it means the type of the environment a proton has. Like this is a type of proton, is an OH type of proton. And we'll see many more types. You got the proton on an aldehyde group, you got a proton on a benzene ring, you got a proton on a phenol group, you got a proton on an amine, amide. So a proton on a carbon with a halogen, a proton on a carbon with a double bond, so many different types. You're going to see a lot of types. Like literally, like I'll show you some examples. You would see a hydrogen on a carbon with a halogen. You're going to see a hydrogen on a carbon with a double bonded O. You're going to see a hydrogen on oxygen with an acid group. You can see a hydrogen on a carbon with a double bonded. You can see a hydrogen on a carbon with a triple bond also. A hydrogen on an N. A hydrogen on an N with a CO, which is different from amine. So these are all different types of protons. And by the way, these are all different functional groups. Abhi to humne hydrocarbon ki baat hi nahi ki hai, which is just an H on a carbon with three single other bonds. So what I've just drawn here are different types of protons. Okay? So I would like you to take this down before we continue. So after having taken this down, let's go to the next slide. So in slide 39, the chemical shift of each peak gives me the structure and environment of the proton. So basically, all the protons that you just made have a certain x-axis value. And that value tells me that this will be the environment. For example, if I get a value near 12, it tells me, for example, that it must be a carboxylic acid. For example. So, to talk about this, I'll show you the type of protons first. Now, this table is a little more easier to read than the data booklet. So first, I'll show you this table, and then the data booklet that was given to you as a separate page, because I forgot that you guys don't have data booklets in these notes. So here are, guys, a mini table of some, what we call, type of proton. Now, this column, by the way, represents what? The type of proton means it represents the type of environment. That's what a type of proton means. This is this environment. H on a carbon atom, but not next to any other functional groups. Meaning, these are either carbons or hydrogens. Not a functional group. But the bottom two are similar but different. This environment is H on a carbon atom bonded to the carbonyl of an ester linkage or an acid linkage. But this is H on a carbon bonded to the carbonyl of aldehydes or ketone. But because they are almost so similar, look at the values, they're almost similar. But they are different environments, but values are similar. So that's why you might get confused, because what if you get a value of 2.3 or 4? It's a reason values are ranges, by the way, because ranges kyun hai? Because they differ. Even, for example, an H on, let's say, ethyl ethanoate will be different from an H on methyl propanoate. So that will have a different value. So these values are given to you in a range. Now I'm just saying, if you got a value as 2.3, you can tell, is it an H on a carbon with an ester linkage or H on a carbon with an aldehyde or ketone linkage. So in the data booklet, we combine this because they're so similar to each other. H on a carbon with C double bond O, H on a carbon with C double bond CO. But both are H on a carbon that is bonded to a carbonyl carbon. That is a CO. See? This is not an exhaustive list. This is just an exploratory list. The exhaustive list is the Cambridge list. But these are some other type of protons. There are other type of protons. For example, if you happen to be a hydrogen on a methyl group or any alkyl group on a benzene ring, hydrogen on the carbon of the alkyl group on a benzene ring, not the long chain. Like, for example, if I'm talking about, let's say, ethyl benzene. Now, these two H's will be on a carbon that's bonded to the benzene ring. That's this guy. So these two hydrogens are this type of proton. But the last one, these three, are H's on a carbon that is not bonded to a functional group. That is the guy we saw here. And main ek baat bata dun, look at these values. They're actually going to increase, not decrease. This is the lowest value you'll ever get. And this is always of a carbon on a simple alkyl group, like a CH3 or a CH2, but has no functional groups near it. That's important. Because as you get towards functional groups, the values will increase. As you get towards benzene, the values will increase. Like as you get to a functional group, like even halogen, the value will increase. See, now the H on a carbon has a halogen, the value is near 3 to 4 ke beech mein kahin. If the H is on a carbon that's single bonded to an O, this is found in alcohols. And this is found in esters. And so their values are different also. And then the H on an alcohol is different. So your job is to be able to match all of these. Like, ye bhi aapko kahan kahan milenge? For example, you'll get to understand that these kind of structures will be found in ester linkages or alcohol. Like, अगर अल्कोहल में आपके पास है, रिमेंबर हमने एग्जांपल किया था CH3 CH2 OH, एंड वी हैड सेड कि यार दिस इज वन प्रोटॉन, दिस इज अनदर प्रोटॉन, दिस इज अनदर वन, द OH, दिस गाय इज दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोटॉन, H और एन O, H और एन O. इसकी जो पीक है उसकी हाइट क्या होगी, 1, एंड वी विल फाइंड इट एनीवेयर बिटवीन 0.5 एंड 5 ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस. देन वी गो टू CH2. This is on an A, both of these H's are on a carbon bonded to O. H on a carbon bonded to O. So these two will be found somewhere here. And these three are H's on a carbon bonded to a C. So they will be found somewhere like the first one. So I'll go over this with more detail though. Don't worry about it. When I look at the exam, the data booklet, I'll talk about more. Then the last three, these are all oxygen, by the way. We'll talk about nitrogen also. But this is the hydrogen on a benzene ring. And look at the value. How many? 6.728. Huh. So a normal benzene ring will have 6 of these. But what if it is methyl benzene? So first of all, in PNK, these are three types of protons. We saw them earlier. There were about three. And in this pick, how many will be? These 5 remain, 6 won't be. So there will be 5 in this range. So there will be a peak in this range that will have a height of 5. Unless, of course, you had an extra OH also. Then if you have this example, then you won't have 5. You will actually have a peak for H's on a C, like a methyl benzene. You'll have an H on a phenol group, that's a different proton, and ye char iske honge phir. So you'll have 3 in one peak, these 4 in this range, and this 1 in a range that the data booklet will show. So I'm going to scroll over to the side and talk about the data booklet value. You guys were given that photocopy. So now this is how the data booklet will tell you the type of protons. You have a long list. So there a larger category and the environment. There are three different types of protons generally. But it's also a type of proton here, but they've labeled this type of proton. Okay, there is an H on a C, an H on an O, and H on an N. But H on a C, KB, these are different types of protons. Because you would be wrong to say that these are not types of protons, because they are, their environments are different. So they are individually all types of protons. Now, so some of the things we saw earlier, I want to say it again. Remember the first example we saw was H on a C. But Cambridge does a beautiful thing. They gives you all the three options. It's not just saying H on a C. It's showing you CH3, which is H on a C. H on a CH2 is also H is on a C. And H on a C, singly. But iska matlab hai ki their next guy is also having no functional group. These are those guys jinke next bonds. You know, ye bond dikha hai, ye bhi dikha hai, ye bhi dikha hai, ye bhi dikha hai. These are also alkyl groups. Matlab, if there is a functional group, it has to be from the next to the next guy. Like for example, this, if I'm talking about CH3, CH2, OH, you'll say, well, ye to CH3 ye ra, aur ye CH2 ye ra. It's not the case. This CH3 is there. But when it's written CH2 like this, it's implied that dono taraf carbon aa raha hai. इसके दोनों तरफ कार्बन नहीं है. सो दिस इज नॉट दिस. दिस CH2 वुड बी द CH2 लाइक दिस. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट मी मेक प्रोपेनॉल. यू सी प्रोपेनॉल, प्रोपेनॉल राइट हियर. नाउ दिस CH3 वुड बी दिस चेन, बिकॉज CH3 नेक्स्ट टू अ कार्बन. दिस CH2, विच कैन बी लेबल्ड एज HBs, लेट्स से इट्स कॉल्ड HAs एंड HBs एंड HCs. An HD. HBs are a CH2 jiske left ki taraf bhi carbon hai, right ki taraf bhi carbon hai. So HB is also this guy. The type is similar. But obviously we know they're not the same. They're not the same guys. Like yesterday's class, you would say there are how many environments? There are 4 different environments. Symmetrical to nahi tha nahi hai. But in dono ka jo data booklet bol raha hai, it's clumping them into the same category. But that's why there's a range given, because this will have a different value and this will have a different value. But the values will be within this range. The reason why we don't give you individual values are because then There'll be so many individual values, and aap kitno ko dekhoge? Because you will realize that you should use this value as just a andaza, as just an starting point. We won't be using this to confirm most molecules anyways. But we are talking about this, so I'm doing this right now. Anyways, so now this CH2 is not the same as this CH2. This is the alkane CH2 because dono taraf carbon atoms hain. But HCs are not an alkane CH2. They are CH2s jiske the carbon is bonded to the O. You see that O? That's right there. You see that? So this is your HC. And so they'll be found near 3. So this peak will be a peak of 3 in this range. HB will also be a peak of 2, a peak of 2 in this range. HC will be a peak of how many? 2 in this range. And OH, that is lower than this in your data booklet, but isme sare aapke dekho detailed examples aage. H on a haloalkane, H on an O carbon with the H on a carbon with the oxygen, chlorine, bromine. These are H's on a alkyl group to the benzene ring. These are H's on the carbonyl carbon. So your job will be to be able to find these guys in the molecule they want you to find. For example, one other example ke le lete na hum. Let's say mere paas hai CH3 CO OCH3. Now how many different environments do I have in this? 2. So isko bol dete hain HA, isko bol dete hain HB. And you can do that, you can say HA and HB. So HA, first of all, ye jo kal ka kaam tha, how many different environments we have. Now their x-axis values ke liye I'll find the chemical shift. So HA or HB ka ab main table mein dhoondunga. HA is what? HAs are hydrogens on a carbon next to a CO. So that's this CH3 CO. So these guys are going to be somewhere between delta 2.2 to 3. Chemical shift values are given in deltas, and we don't care about where they come from. Obviously there's a science, but that's not in the syllabus. There you have to match the values. And if I ask you, bhai, iski value kya x-axis pe HB ki? HB is CH3O. Where is CH3O? CH3O right there. So that will be found somewhere between 3.2 and 4. And literally your graph will look like this. Now one thing to know about the graph, and we'll have to remember that, is that it starts from the right. Okay? And here, the graph of this will literally have two peaks. One will be near 2.2 and 3 ke beech mein kar dete, and one will be between 3 and 4 ke beech mein. Height of 3, height of 3. So the other part of the table that is still part of the same table in your notes, but I have it in over 2, is that the OH and the NH, these are also hydrogen bonded, but we'll talk about that later. These are H's on an O and H's on an N. Where do I find H's on an O? I find them in normal alcohols, phenols and acids. Alcohols ki jo H ki range hai, wo 0.5 to 6 ki badi range hai. But phenols ki is more than that, is 4.5 to 7. And further larger value is the acid. This is the largest value there is. Or from the graph, this will be the leftmost value. Because remember, the values will be from left to, from right to left. So from right to left. And NH kahan kahan hota hai? NH hota hai amine or amide. Amine mein bhi you got the restriction amine and you got the phenylamine. Right? So, what do you want to use this for? We want to use this for stuff like this. Okay, for example, what if I had CH3CO, O, CH2, CH3. This is a very popular or ester, ethyl ethanoate. And yesterday we did what, guys? Yesterday we had done that this would be one particular environment, this would be another one, and this will be HC. And today we've discussed that where will I find HA on the graph, HB on the graph, and HC on the graph. We know the heights of these. HA ki height kya hogi? 3. HB, 2. HC. So basically, I know these will be 3 peak, 3 ki height ki peak, 2 ki height ki peak, and 3 ki height ki peak. Now I want to know that today's we're doing is discussing the x-axis value. Where will I find this? So HA is CH3CO. HC is CH3 on an alkyl chain. And HB is H on a C with a single bonded O. So let's find these in our table. The first one, CH3CO, is right here. CH3CO, 2.2 and 3. The second one was CH2O, right there. 3.2 to 4. And the last one is CH3O. No, sorry, CH3CH2. That's this one right here. So one is 2.5, 1 3.5, 1 is near 1. So that's what I have. So approximately, this one will be near 2.5 delta. This one will be near 3.5. And this will be near 1. No, sorry, what am I doing? I did ulta. Yeah, this will be near 3.5. And this will be near 1. So literally a graph would be like this. And once you can make the graph, therefore you can even dissect the graph. I'm just making a sketch. They won't ask you to make it. But one is at the height of 3 at 1. Then approximately 2.5 mein hogi height of another height of 3. And then height of 2. Like this. 3, 3, 2. This is between 2 and 3. So between 2 and 3, you'll find the height of 3. And between 3 and 4, you'll have the height of 2. Do you follow this? Okay. So after having done this example, we move on to going over this lastly. So the understand that the values that we just saw are approximate values, and they depend on other groups that we attach. That's why we give you a range, just to prove this. It's just to prove, and if you can don't get it, it's okay. But it's just to prove, show you, okay, how does the same environment have different values? Is that here are three carbonyls. All three have C double bond O, ethanol, propanone, and methyl butanone. Butanone, butanone. And all these three, man, you aap dekhe na? Look at this group, a CH3 group. This is an orange. CH3, the right one is the rightmost one, CH3. All of these CH3s are bonded to C double bond O. But pehle wale mein is 2.2, the second wale mein is 2.1, and the third wale mein is 2.1. Even that changes. Then, think about the other guy in green and pink. The green wala is the second wale mein, it's on a carbon that is bonded to the O. And the pink wala is also on a carbon that's single bonded to the CO. Exact same. But the difference comes from the fact that this carbon has another H. But this carbon doesn't have another H. So even that, look at the change in values. So the values fluctuate a bit. That's why there's a range from, let's say, 2.1 to 2.7, depending on other guys bonded to it, other hydrogens bonded to it. Okay? So, don't worry about it. That's why we have a range. Now, but don't worry about that. Just remember that when you use a table, you just must understand to find the best matching of the proton environment. Okay? And I'm actually going to skip slides 48 and 49. Thoda bahut dekh sakte hum. Yeah, the idea was that because I wanted to talk about the values are a little different, but you see, let's look at this molecule and the graph. We kind of get an idea now why this is. Because you got propanol, we got CH3, CH2, CHO. So we got the three H's, that's HA, we got the three CH2s, that's HBs, and the aldehydes is HC. And so there are three peaks, heights of 3 is to 2 is to 1. The guy that's HA3 is an alkyl group on a carbon atom. So this will be the guy near 1, if you notice. And height will be of 3. The middle guy is H on a C bonded to the carbonyl carbon CO. If you remember, this was near 2.1 ki to 2.7 ki range mein. And that peak is somewhere between 2.1 and 2.7 ki range mein. And is a height of? Kitni? 2. And the last is an H on an aldehyde carbon, which was near 9 to 11 ki vichmata, I think. Data booklet mein. Alright? Now that's how we use data booklet. Now the problem with chemical structure is because their ranges, they're not exact. But there's another exact way of finding out the structure without even worrying about chemical shift values. And that comes from a high resolution NMR. Now, and that's what really we're going to be doing in the exam. You're going to be doing high resolution NMR. So the last thing about NMR we're discussing right now. And this makes it much easier to find the arrangement of hydrogens in a molecule. Now, let me show you the resolution, the low and high resolution NMRs in a second. But look at the molecule. This is a CH2Cl2, CH2Cl. It's 1,1,2 trichloroethane. But this is one environment of how many hydrogens? One. And this will be another environment of hydrogens. Kitne? Two. So there will be two peaks, heights of one and two. And that's simple enough graph. And that's what I see on the leftmost graph. I'll see a height of one, two and a height of one from this molecule. And why? The H1 labeled here is the guy, there's only one of them on the whole chain. So that's one height. And the two H's, two and three, are identical environments, so they have a height of two. But now this is a low resolution. What you've seen so far has been low resolution. High resolution is high resolution because you're getting a much more clearer picture. You're actually having a much more high res signal coming out. And what you do is, what you realize is that this peak, one ki thi na, it's not really a peak of one. It's three smaller peaks together. And this peak of two was not really a peak of one. Sorry, this peak of blue is not really a peak of one. It's actually a peak of two. And we call a two together is called a doublet, and three together is called a triplet. We'll talk about why. But this is what we discovered. We'll talk about why in a second, Abhi. But this is what we discovered. That the graph in high res was not just single peaks. The big peak was a doublet and the small one was a triplet. A doublet means it's broken into two smaller peaks. Triplet means broken into three smaller peaks. Okay. So what I'm going to say is in the next couple of slides, but I'm going to leave the graph here. Now, why does this happen? Now, there is a science behind why the splitting happens. And the basic science is this, that the graph is, by the way, the graph comes from a system where energy is being absorbed. And the energy absorbed can be modified by the, like, because these guys' ka signal can be modified by the presence of H1. The H2 and H3 signal can be tampered with by having this guy. Because of obviously energy and magnetism, hence the name nuclear magnetic resonance. But again, the apparatus is not in our work. What is in our work? What we need to know is that what this means in terms of the graph. What it means is that if a proton is on a carbon atom whose adjacent carbon atom has two protons, then that peak is split 2+1 ways. मतलब कहने का H1 के adjacent carbon के दो proton थे तो H1 is split 2+1 ways, three ways. H2 and 3 are one peak, right? Because they're the same. And they are on a carbon whose adjacent carbon is this one, which has how many protons? No, one. H2 and 3 are on a carbon that has only one proton. So the peak will be split 1+1 ways. So the rule is that jitne aapke, if you have, and so this is, let me also give you terminology. If I'm talking about H1, then this is the carbon H1 is on, and this is the adjacent carbon. So you can call, for H1, you can call H2 and 3 adjacent protons. That's easier to call them. Because what are adjacent protons? They are protons on the adjacent carbon atom. So H1 ke adjacent protons kon hai? H2 and 3. H2 ka adjacent protons sirf H1. These two are the same environment. Adjacent means bonded to the adjacent carbon atom. And the rule is that the peak signal that the particular proton is going to give will be split n+1 ways, where n is the number of adjacent protons. And that's said in slide number 52. In a high resolution spectrum, each peak is going to be split up. Is going to split up n+1 ways is if n is the number of adjacent atoms. I'll give you an example. Similar example to what we just saw. This is an example of 1,1,2 tribromo ethane. So 1,1,2. So if I'm talking about the peak due to this hydrogen, its adjacent protons are these two. Two adjacent protons. So iski peak will be split how many ways? Three ways, 2+1. If I'm talking about this guy, this proton, if I'm talking about these protons absorbing, then their adjacent carbon atom has one proton only. So in dono ki peak will be split 1 plus 1 ways, 2 ways. Okay. Now, you only talk about adjacent protons, not the protons on the same atom. So if a CH3 is bonded to something, these three H's do not affect their own peak. But they will affect a peak of adjacent carbon atoms. Only protons on adjacent carbon atoms will affect splitting. Okay? For example, I'll take another example. Chloroethane. Very simple guy. CH3, CH2, Cl. Now, these three, the peak is will have a height of 3 because of these guys. But it will be split X number of ways. Which number? How many number of ways? It will be split. Adjacent carbon ke protons kitne hain? 2 hain. So 2 plus 1 ways. 3 ways. And this peak will have a height of 2. But it will be split 4 ways because is proton ke adjacent proton hain? Ye, 3. So this peak, let me repeat again. There are two different protons. And I'll say, I won't say this and that. I'll label them. Main H3 ko bolta hun, HAs hain mere ye. So all the three H's and CH3 are HAs, for example, and all the two H's and CH2 are HBs. So my HA ki peak will have a height of? Will have a height of? 3. And it'll split X 2 plus 1 ways. 3 ways. HB will have a height of? 2. But it'll split 3 plus 1, 4 ways. Alright? And splitting 3 ways is called triplet, splitting 4 ways is called quartet. So this is what you see. Right here. So the height of 3 is split 3 ways because the adjacent proton were 2. And the height of 2 is split 3 ways. Now, and I want you to focus on this because this is a very common phenomenon if any molecule has an ethyl group. If you have an ethyl group, what you have is a CH3 and a CH2 group. One peak will have a height of 3, one will have a height of 2. But having a height of 3, in this particular case, this peak also split how many ways? 3 ways. Now understand that this single peak now gives me information about two different environments. It first tells me that I have a CH3. But because it split 3 ways, it's a triplet, it means it has two hydrogens on the adjacent carbon atom. Isko le lo, to iski height kitni hai? 2. So this is a CH2. But it split how many ways? 4 ways. Which means iska jo adjacent carbon tha uspe 3 hydrogen hai. And together this says it's a CH2 with a CH3. This is a CH2 with a CH3. So this is a CH3 with a CH2. And that's why together these two peaks are very common in molecules that have CH3, CH2. Because this is for CH3 and this is for CH2. But this is CH3 split 3 ways because it's adjacent to a CH2. This is CH2 split 4 ways because adjacent to a CH3. And that's what I was saying in slide 57, 58. So you can read that stuff. Now, if a peak is split 2 ways, it's called a doublet. 3 ways is called a triplet. 4 ways is called a quartet. You won't be dealing with more than this. Anything more than this, you'll be calling it a multiplet. Multiple splits. 1 way is called, be called a singlet. When you get a singlet, it would simply mean that the protons that you are, your adjacent carbon atom will have no protons. For example, let's just talk about that. For example, I have CH3, CO, O, CH2, CH3. Now this is fun. This is ethyl ethanoate. I brought the same molecule back. But isme hum x-axis ki baat nahi karenge, hum sirf baat karenge splitting pattern. So let's label them first. Let's call the three H's as HAs, these two as HBs, and these three as HC. Now HA, tell me about HA. HA will have a height of 3, and it'll split how many ways? Split hoga singlet. Why? Because the adjacent carbon has no proton. Is that false? Why are you following that? Then HB ko le lo. HB kya hoga? HB ki height kitni hogi? 2. Height or area. Remember, I'm using height as like area, okay? It's really area, but Cambridge will give you the height value. And Again, I'm ignoring the x-axis value because I'm going to tell you that it's done without that also. So now this is what?
Four.
It'll be split how many ways? Four ways, because the adjacent carbon is three. So it'll be a quartet. A quartet. And the last one, HC. It's a height of how much? Three. The first it'll be a height of three. And it'll split be how many ways? Three ways, because the adjacent is HBs and there are two of them only. So it is a triplet. Okay. So let's check this out. So now moving on to slide number 60. Now let's look at some common splitting patterns. Now HA or HB ki baat kar rahe. And now you can guess it. We already done this now already. HA means it's on a carbon atom whose adjacent proton is only one. So its peak will have a height of one and it'll split also now two ways. Split doublet ho jayegi iski. And HB ka adjacent carbon pe ek hi proton, so that also will be a doublet. We're not going to be dealing with a carbon with two different carbons on either side having protons. We'll talk about that later. Right now you'll only have a pair of carbons. So imagine there's no other carbon here or no other carbon here. So HA is on a carbon, jiska adjacent carbon is CH2. So HA ki jo peak hai, it'll have a height of one, but it'll split how many ways? Three ways. And HB will have a height of two, and adjacent protons kitne hai iske? One. So it'll also split two ways. This is both CH2, CH2. So HA has an adjacent proton two. So it'll split three ways. And HB's adjacent protons are also two. So it'll split 2 plus 1, 3 ways. And this is the most common one. A CH2 CH. I already showed you guys this. A CH3 means that if you're HA, your adjacent protons are CH3s, you'll split 4 ways. And look at the splitting pattern also. The ratio of the height, we'll talk about that tomorrow. And HB's peak will have a height of 3, but split also 3 ways. Yeah? And this is one other example of CH3 with a CH. So HA here has three CH3s, so that's split four ways. But CH3s will have only one remaining proton, so split two ways. Are you guys following this? Okay. So we'll end this hill here, and tomorrow's class becomes